This video is kindly sponsored by Keeps. More on them later on. Hey, 42 here. Sometime in the late 1880s, the lifeless body of a young woman was fished out of the River Seine that flows through Paris. The girl looked to be about 16 years of age, and since there wasn't a mark on her, it was assumed she died by drowning, perhaps having committed suicide. Attempts were made to identify the young woman in the days after her body was recovered from the water, but nobody knew who she was, and no friends or family ever came forward to claim her. To this day, her true identity remains an intriguing mystery. But despite the twin handicaps of being both dead and of unknown entity, this woman went on to infiltrate thousands of homes across Europe and inspire some of the greatest artists in history, from Pablo Picasso to Michael Jackson. She's even earned the unofficial title of being the most kissed person of all time. An unusual accolade that's helped her save millions of lives around the world. As confusing and unlikely as all of that may sound, believe me, it's completely true. Stick around and all will soon become clear. Because this is the utterly remarkable and largely forgotten story of the unknown woman of the Seine. A girl who died in obscurity in Paris 130 years ago, but who lives on today in the most unexpected and incredible way. Now, I want to take a moment to talk about hair loss, because I've had people close to me start to lose their hair as early as their 20s, and it's always been an upsetting experience. If you're in the same boat, then you're not alone. Did you know 2 out of 3 guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they're 35? But the best thing you can do to prevent hair loss is take the initiative now and do something about it whilst you've still got hair left. I like Keeps because it makes treatment super easy by delivering your hair loss medication every 3 months, so you could say goodbye to awkward doctor visits and waiting in pharmacy checkout lines. There's a good reason that Keeps has more 5-star reviews than any of its competitors, and hundreds of thousands of men trust them for their hair loss prevention medication. So, if you're like me, you're probably not ready to lose your hair just yet. But prevention is key. The faster you act, the faster you'll see results. And the sooner you start using Keeps, the more hair you'll save. If you're noticing that you're losing your hair, do something about it. For a limited time, go to keeps.com/42. Or click the link in the description below to receive 50% off your first order. Like all good stories, this one starts in a morgue. The Paris Morgue, to be precise, a building which in the late 19th century could be found right in the heart of the French capital, just a stone's throw away from Notre Dame Cathedral. This prominent location was no coincidence. It had been carefully selected by city officials to ensure the morgue attracted as many visitors as possible. That might seem like an odd goal for a morgue. You'd think keeping the numbers down would be preferable in a place for the dead, but this wasn't your average funeral parlour. In fact, at the time, the Paris Morgue was one of the city's most popular tourist attractions. People from all over the city and far beyond flocked to its public viewing gallery to get a good look at the day's fresh corpses, which were laid out like exhibits in a museum. If the morgue staff were feeling particularly creative, they'd sometimes dress the dead in fancy clothes and place them in lifelike positions, adding to the surreal spectacle. As weird as all of that may sound, there was actually a fairly sensible explanation for this apparently macabre behaviour. Well, not the dressing up part. I've no idea what all of that was about. But the rest of it, at least. Making the morgue accessible to the public spared officials the time-consuming job of tracking down the relatives of the city's growing number of unidentified dead. If a loved one went missing, instead of sitting at home worrying, you could simply pop your head in at the morgue and make sure they weren't dead. But whilst the reasoning was sound, sort of, opening the Paris morgue up to Joe public had some unexpected consequences, driven by an irrefutable fact of human nature. One that can be proved easily enough with a spare 5 minutes and a reliable internet connection. We humans are a bit f***ed up. Which is why, as well as concerned relatives searching for missing loved ones, the Paris morgue was visited by basically everybody. It became so popular that it even began appearing in the city's guidebooks and tourist pamphlets, alongside world-famous museums and galleries. Interest in the morgue was further fueled by grisly stories in the newspapers, which presented Parisians with a new and unique form of entertainment. They could read about a brutal murder in the paper in the morning, then head to the morgue to get a good look at the mutilated body of the victim in the afternoon. By all accounts, a lovely way to spend a Sunday. The most popular attractions, well, rotting corpses, are said to have brought in as many as 40,000 spectators a day and spawned extensive side industries for both vendors and pickpockets. The particular corpse I want to tell you about today, the so-called Unknown Woman of the Seine, was not, so far as we know, one of the morgue's high-profile attractions, or at least no official records survive of her time there. But that doesn't mean she didn't get her fair share of attention. When the morgue's bodies weren't being dressed up in funny clothes for no reason whatsoever, they were usually laid out pretty much naked. Which is why, in those more sexually repressed times, a young woman at the morgue was always a source of keen interest. Whilst there were no doubt plenty of admiring glances from members of the public, it was one of the morgue's own members of staff who really took a shine to this dead woman. So much so that when no relatives came forward to claim her body, this man decided to take the young girl home with him instead. Not her rotting corpse, obviously. That would be mental. No, he decided to take a plaster cast of the unknown woman's face so that he could admire it from the privacy of his own home for the rest of his days. The creepy bastard. In truth, there might not have been anything especially sinister about the man's actions. Unsettling though they may sound, it was the morgue's custom that unclaimed bodies be taken away after 3 days and buried in unmarked graves. They were usually starting to fall apart by that stage anyway. The death mask may simply have been a way of recording the girl's features just in case anyone came looking for her. Either way, the cast was made, a near-perfect reproduction of the dead girl's face. Exactly how that cast came to be reproduced in greater quantities isn't clear, but in time, the unknown woman of the Seine's face began to appear on the walls and mantelpieces of houses first across Paris, and then far beyond. For whatever reason, something about that serene, almost blissful face just got under people's skin, especially those with creative tendencies. A generation of European writers took it turns to invent their own backstory for this nameless girl. Some painted her as an orphan, others as a witch or the victim of a crime. Vladimir Nabokov, author of the enormously controversial novel Lolita, is said to have owned and treasured a copy of the death mask, and the great Pablo Picasso hung one on the wall of his studio. It was another philosopher and Nobel Prize-winning author, Albert Camus, another proud owner of the death mask, who noticed its resemblance to another well-known Parisian resident, the Mona Lisa. And you have to admit, there is something to that comparison. Those enigmatic half-smiles are almost eerily similar. Quite the coincidence, considering the unknown woman of the Seine was pulled from the river less than 200 meters away from where Da Vinci's masterpiece hangs in the Louvre to this day. Perhaps unsurprisingly, considering she seemed to have cast a spell on some of the most influential artists and thinkers of the day, the unknown woman of the Seine came to embody the era's concept of beauty. Some commenters have gone so far as to claim that an entire generation of German models and film stars styled themselves on this anonymous drowned girl's face. Over time, the death mask's popularity began to wane. And if that's where this story ended, there's a good chance it would have been entirely forgotten by now. But about 65 years after the unknown woman's death, a twist of fate brought her back to life again in spectacular fashion. During the 1950s, a group of doctors, including Austrian Peter Saffer, were in the process of laying the foundations for cardiopulmonary resuscitation, better known by its catchier nickname, CPR. Today, CPR is one of the most widely known and widely used emergency medical procedures in the world. But in the 50s, it was brand new, with around 3/4 of all cardiac arrests taking place outside of hospitals. Peter Saffer recognized the potential for CPR to save countless lives. And so he was keen to begin teaching this technique to as many people as he could. The problem was, CPR is a tricky thing to practice. What they don't show you in the movies is that CPR is a fairly brutal procedure. Try it out on a friend, and you're liable to break her ribs. But Saffer had hit on a novel idea to overcome this painful little issue. He wanted to create a life-size doll to be used in CPR training scenarios. It just so happens that Saffer was mates with a toy maker by the name of Asmund Leerdal, who had all the know-how necessary to bring the project to life. Not only that, but Leerdal had saved his 2-year-old son from drowning some years before, and he knew the value of first aid training better than anyone. Leerdal figured that he should make the doll female, since macho types in the 1950s would have been unwilling to lock lips with a doll of their own gender. The design was coming along well, except for one thing. The doll needed a face, and it was here that Leerdal remembered that oddly enchanting cast of a young woman that had hung for years in a relative's house. As I'm sure you've guessed by now, the cast was of the unknown woman of the Seine. By 1960, Leerdal's doll with the drowned girl's face was on sale under the name of Resusci Anne. It was the first patient simulator ever made, and over the next 60 years or so, it would be used to train literally hundreds of millions of people in the use of CPR, which in turn has saved an estimated 2 million lives and counting. It's for this reason the unknown woman of the Seine has been called the most kissed person in the world. I know that's kind of cheating, but hey, I didn't make it up. Resusci Anne has been sold all over the world, but in the US she's typically known as CPR Annie. One of the steps taught to those learning CPR is to check whether the patient's responsive by asking her a question. When using the CPR Annie doll, that question is usually, "Annie, are you okay?" No doubt that phrase sounds familiar, because it's one of the most famous lyrics in all of pop music, sung by Michael Jackson on the 1988 single Smooth Criminal. That isn't just a coincidence either. I don't know if you've ever listened to the lyrics, but Smooth Criminal is about a woman being attacked and badly injured in her apartment. The famous chorus is an allusion to CPR Annie, and therefore, the unknown woman of the Seine. Whether or not the King of Pop ever knew he was singing about a drowned girl who'd been dead for hundreds of years, I guess we'll never know. I should point out that some people have questioned whether the unknown woman of the Seine really was found dead in the river all those years ago. Her face is remarkably well preserved, something that isn't often seen with bodies that have spent a significant amount of time in water, though it isn't unheard of. It's been suggested that she was instead a model, a deceased tuberculosis sufferer, or possibly the daughter of a German mask maker. Though there's no compelling evidence to support those claims either. Whoever she was, and however she died, one thing's for certain. The unknown woman of the Seine has lived one hell of an afterlife. Thanks for watching.